The ADE651 stood for Advanced Detection Equipment, and it certainly looked the part. Sleek black casing, a swiveling antenna said to detect everything from bombs to $100 bills, and a card that indicated what the device had found. This is the man behind the device, James McCormick, in this video leading a training session on the ADE-651 to police in Niger by a live minefield.
Hey, I'm very, very happy.
But they don't work. British police say the ADE-651 is really the Gopher, a novelty golf ball finder with the label removed. This device, independent tests show, has no better than a random chance at finding a golf ball, much less a bomb.
And these devices contain absolutely nothing inside. There's no known laws of science or physics that these devices could work. He is a con man. He uses sleight of hand and absurd sales tactics to actually con governments, officials, private individuals out of money to buy these devices.
McCormick spent less than 18 months as an entry-level policeman in the Liverpool area before becoming a salesman of radio equipment. But in this training video to potential salesmen in India, he said he had, quote, worked with explosives for British police. It was the Made in the UK label that tipped British police off. They found that McCormick had the components made separately, then assembled them here at a cost of less than $60 each. He sold the devices to government agencies and private companies around the world, in at least one case, for as much as $300,000 apiece. Iraq's law enforcement agencies bought 6,000 of the devices to scan for explosives at checkpoints. So just how much money did James McCormick make off this scam? An estimated $60 to $80 million, and he spent $8 million of it on this historic home in Bath, England, formerly owned by Hollywood star Nicolas Cage, complete with a pool in the basement. He also bought a million-dollar yacht and holiday homes in Cyprus and Florida, assets the police are now trying to seize.
What we intend to do is ensure that his assets are confiscated and that we get the money back from them, so he can't live a life of luxury from this crime.
McCormick insists the devices do work, but he has been convicted of fraud. Yet the ADE-651 is still in use in Iraq and other countries, potentially putting lives at risk. Atika Schubert, CNN, Somerset, England.